Valle. My name is Jorge Cor. I talk in this moment from Chile, Latin America. Do you hear me fine? Is everything okay?
Yes.
Okay. Let's start. This presentation is about the metaphor and personalization through mobile implementation and heritage content. In this model, I make that Rafael García Ginebra. And the first part that I produced, I talk about almost the phenomena producing the territory have to be strongly influenced by the context suggested by ICT, ranging from the singular representations or level of the spatial scenarios, even the possibility of taking and structuring places from the new and complex data structures, like I already before. With the development of processing techniques and methodologies, the radical display. From its beginning, as a social being, the humankind has been involved with the territory, landscape, and places, creating several tools conditional open door historical context for understanding these systems. From the simple graph paper, like a map, housing the compass and astrolabe and system of coordinates, like the total longitude, to the current digital complexes of the implementation of map servers, cloud navigation satellites like GPS, and collaborative information about these tools, elements of the web 2.0 and 3.0. And these technical tools like augmented reality have developed in the last 25 years, strongly complemented by the exponential increase in hardware capabilities, both in stationary and mobile devices. Isn't this the late case and mobile devices? Where important in Twitter and things, allowing a greater number of related content, the generation activities for augmented reality. This has increased with the application of this technology in various fields of knowledge, which highlight an education and territorial heritage, where they have been in systematic concept. Creating a new way of presenting and disseminating themes present in territory. Another story that has been strengthened by advances in portability that by these devices has been the mobile navigation, allowing the development of various constants, different systems, with consequences on the in the work in the digital implementation. This works and with a mobile system and application led to the mobile pedestrian navigation and augmented reality with the framework of the territorial information corresponding to historical and cultural heritage of the cities of Salamanca and Santiago de Chile. We work in the design and development of the mobile pedestrian navigation and augmented reality application, where we define the architecture, functionality, interface, and implementation. What is the object of the creation of this application? The object is arises from the technological area and implementation of the application and in the first part, we are determining the requirements concerning a territorial and heritage context in this platform, establishing territorial scenarios and deploying content in the application, having as a starting point spatial analysis and digital information of the data. In a second stage, the first user development context, augmented reality, mobile pedestrian navigation was analyzed in order to have a diagnosis of existing implementations, the strengths quickly. Finally, the development of the augmented reality and mobile pedestrian navigation module is raised through the frameworks of location, navigation, augmented reality available in the programs and application of mobile devices. Particularly those related of the table, to tablet, iPads, speakerly. Allowing the deployment of content on heritage and territory. What is the arrival context? In the first part, this part is about the learning and augmented reality. Augmented reality in the macro context is the technology input dynamic committee, not the real world, and with said data, generated by the public by this piece. And the second part, we talk about the model detection system. It's a user-device process for navigation is done in a context of human scale, one-to-one, assisted by different sensors and mobile tools, GPS, sensors, locations, hydrophob, etc. Finally, we try to explore these elements at the methodological in a technological, pedagogical for technology feedback and learning objects. And the fiber will have a significant impact on the impact on this type of the application and is good for the learning about heritage. Moreover, from the solution of the thematic content of the object of heritage data, the recognition of contemporary state with methodology detects learning objects. Sponsor models that identify the types of knowledge that need to master to proper incorporated technologies in teaching and learning, which is the fact of any digital or digital entity that uses for teaching and in the educational context. What about the methodology that the research developed? Five is said about the creator of application. In the first part, we define the input data of the application, specifically the elicitation of the requirement of the application development. This includes information about the definition of the territorial area and heritage context, about values, type of data, structure, storage type, and interoperability, and additional information about the augmented reality models, speech, text, and data. And a single stage of this part, with all the output criteria, for displaying information by a graphical user interface developed for a user's mobile context, adapting the content delivered to different heritage systems that we want to use. In parallel, through the use of the model sensor, it's possible to obtain information through the use of spatial temporal to smooth media appeals, allowing doing a subsequent relationship with the educational context. The next part is the requirement analysis and full requirement specifications. This step will present the particular requirement specification of our application, making an analysis of the options that exist today regarding augmented reality, maps, and navigation. This step looks at a set of utilities and features, the information, data, particular content, and website. So the within this analysis should into a further transition to the SDK, augmented reality and map particularly in context of AMS in order to obtain an adequate for the development and implementation of the proposed application tool. The third phase is software design. In software design, at this stage, it is the integrated development environment, IDEA, in this case, Xcode, and Objective-C, and Facebook from the iOS context, complemented with the implementation of these frameworks for the generation of software model environment for iOS. Specifically, we work with the AppKit for location and for object reality Metaio SDK. What's the implementation? An implementation of the application, the language of the development was Objective-C and Swift 2.2. In the beginning, the development of the application was made on Objective-C, but in the period of the production, with the right, all the applications are Swift 2.2. This level is uncompatible with C language structures, meta development are expedited as in clear structure. The experience of the Swift language, perhaps important response in the learning of Apple, for us very important to incorporate this platform to the ORCS application. Include important elements of the United States code, flexible focus on the programming multi-paradigms, object-oriented functionality, imperative and structural syntax, dynamic and sensitive, can persist and interoperate with other languages of the development and model application. Finally, the last phase of this methodology is its verification. We applied several business tests for extended parallel during the development of software, checking each structure separately. iOS interface, map navigation, augmented reality, and heritage information, and subsequently, as a world, we have currently had the development of a beta test. With this version of the application, and in order to achieve the optimized in the field of an empirical research fieldwork in a loop channel context, we proceeded to perform the respective test, emphasizing two particular aspects. First, in reference to internet data access connectivity. Two, verification the accuracy levels of tape devices. And finally, correction to errors arising from the data visualization. Well, what is the conclusion expected results? First, recent advances in model technology and program development elements have increased to levels never before seen. The features and options presented by these devices, particularly in inside targets. Thus, it has been a frustrating something to place them as a whole in a context of mobility that is tables. Right with the regard to iPad technology. A first component that arises as the basis of the mobile application system is development based on the framework known as GoTouch in the iOS environment, which allows the operation of the data in the condition of the user interface and the interaction of the other components that implemented in the mobile application. The following components of the system frameworks development, MapKit and Core Conditions, thereby of the iOS ecosystem for the navigation and digital mapping, allow a physical and spatial interaction from the devices, providing location information and information swallowed through map. This data allows me interactivity between position of sensors, push to search, and graphical structures. In addition, with these tools, the implementation of the navigation system according to purposely obtaining data and heritage results, together with the interaction of the third computing system elements, is about the proper relationship between presentation and data display. Finally, the inclusion of augmented reality resources, which was implemented by a framework of Metairo. Because of their easy incorporation, iOS and development of the PC language, the ability to read 3D objects from the graphic format, diagrams, and .tp models, and optical recognition methodology with over processing image or from QR code to QR code, the process by recognizing shapes and directly information. From the perspective of development itself, application parent has personal challenges and needs. It was on the evolution of the situation surrounding the increasingly rapid progress of touch computer, but with the implementation and reach the product that arise. The most significant change was around the use of the language development. But first, our rest of the objective and advice to include like a piece of development. Finally, 60% has a strong emphasis in the technological aspect and general to better logical allow development in a beautiful world of each element involved in the teach. K-Lash content remain its expectation and I am for that unique educational process. Finally, in this case, the learning and support related like a educational context are elements that have major impact in the development of mobile technology. 3G and 4G labs, platforms, smartphones, and tables. The personalization that and process kinds such as thermal detection, visualization, allows an improvement in the learning process and the incorporation of the cultural identity local. And well, thank you very much for your attention, and I attend for if you have any questions for the presentation. Thank you.